Hi, I'm Laura, and this is Trip Train Trilogy. Today I'll be reviewing Kosmos Episode 1, The Pendant by Jo Linsdell. So, this book is only available in ebook, so I do not have a physical copy, which means I can't hold it up for you. So, I will show a quick pic of the cover in 3, 2, 1. Anyway, I was sent a PDF version of this book by the author because I said that I wanted to read it, but I was too dumb how to figure out Kindle. You know that old family member who's at least middle-aged, probably elderly, who can't understand this newfangled technology? I'm that family member. Except I'm not elderly. Or middle-aged. Anyway, this episode is part of a serialized fiction, which will be a total of 12 episodes, each coming out at the first of a month. This overall series is about Matt, who discovers a pendant that causes him to travel back in time. Throughout these episodes, Matt finds himself in 1600 London in the midst of an assassination plot, in World War II, trapped between the German and Soviet forces, and in the Colosseum in ancient Rome. So these all sound pretty exciting. I have not read to these yet. I've just know this from the episodes that's come out. I've read the descriptions of them. I've only read the first one, which I will be reviewing today. But when I review the later ones, I will link to those reviews from this video. I want to read it is because I'm really interested in history, and having a book that goes through different parts of history sounds really interesting to me. And though usually I prefer big books, I've been so busy, and in fact I'm currently reading a big book which is over 600 pages and it's really dark, and I've been reading it for quite a while, so I wanted something I could read quickly so I could feel accomplished, and also something that wasn't so dark so I could, you know, enjoy myself slightly more instead of being depressed. Don't get me wrong, this story isn't all rainbows and sunshine. In fact, the protagonist, Matt, is dealing with a lot of heavy stuff, and not necessarily in the best way. He's been depressed since his dad died, which has resulted in constant arguing with his mom, and has also resulted in a loss of friends. He's also dealing with bullying and has a crush on a popular girl who doesn't seem to know he exists. I'd like to point out that her name is Samantha Jones, and I went to school with someone named Samantha Jones, which is very important for me to say in this review. Now, I haven't read episodic fiction before, so I'm not sure if I'm correct about this, but I thought it would be sort of like a short story for each section. However, I will say this section felt more like a character introduction of him. Right at the end is when the pendant is introduced, and it felt like that if all these episodes was one big novel, that would be the inciting incident, as opposed to being a short story with an overall arc. And though this setup is short, I would say it is pretty effective at establishing his character, and I do feel like I understand Matt and his struggle. I definitely recommend this for someone who likes seeing character development, who maybe has been bullied or depressed before, because I do feel Matt is pretty relatable, and also I think that his character is really well done and realistic. And again, if you like history, this series is going to go back in time to a bunch of different historical events. So if you're into that, I recommend you read that. Again, when I read the next section, I will link this to it. I will link it to this video. Also, I would like to add that the author actually read a part from this section on her YouTube channel, which is probably my favorite scene in this section. So I will link her reading of that section below, because again, I think it's pretty good, and I will also link it in the card. So now I'm going to go into more in-depth analysis. So, cue analysis. One thing I really like about Matt's character is how he's flawed. He's a bit cowardly, afraid to stand up for himself and others. He's clinging to the past with the loss of his father, and sometimes due to both of these things, he acts selfishly. And also, he's constantly anxious about how he's perceived by others. I find these flaws all make his character more interesting and give him opportunity to grow. And I really love that the author gives Matt these flaws, because I feel like in a lot of books, authors are afraid to make their character too flawed, especially when it comes to being cowardly and to being selfish. And I wouldn't describe Matt as selfish. However, sometimes his fear or his depression causes him to do things that are selfish. And honestly, one of the best things about reading about a character is getting to see them evolve. And I can really see how she's setting up for him to learn and grow as a person through this time travel journey. Even though he's flawed, he is still likable. In fact, a lot of his sorrow and fear is relatable, even if even though I haven't been through the same specific things as him. One thing I've noticed also in a lot of books, it is a common flaw, is that the character's behavior doesn't fit their backstory or even things that happen in the story. I've read books that take place in a time period or a world that has certain values that the character for some reason doesn't hold because the author wants them to be special or more how we would prefer them to be. However, Matt's personality fits perfectly with his backstory and what he's been through. And I feel that his character is very realistic based on what has happened to him, which I really like because I've read a couple books where characters' personalities make no sense based on what's happened to them. Due to this episode being very short, I felt a lot of the side characters weren't as well developed as Matt. Matt's definitely the most well developed. The next two most well developed, I would say, are his mom and his best friend, Alex. And of course, some were more developed than others. Two of them felt more like they were just there to be acted upon and to show and to demonstrate things about other characters, specifically Matt and then also his friend. However, it didn't really feel like it was as big of a problem since it was so short. They felt as developed as they should be based on the length. The bully character, I would say, feels more like an individual, but is a fairly standard bully character. However, I also did find the bully, who's named Eric, very realistic in his behavior by the fact that Eric picks easy targets to pick on, and when confronted by someone, he kind of backs down, because in actuality, most bullies are not actually that tough if they're faced with someone going back at them. And Eric's presence has caused Matt to become very fearful due to bullying, which has also given Matt room to grow as a character. And now I save my favorite side character for last, which is Alex. Alex is Matt's friend. He's brave, he's optimistic, he's kind, and he's selfless. Also, Alex has some of my favorite dialogue along with Matt. And I feel like in another book, Alex would be the protagonist. But I'm glad he's not. Because in a lot of books, the protagonist is always a hero type. They always are brave and selfless if they're those two things. And they really don't have as much room to grow. Whereas the main character's best friend is usually inferior in pretty much every way and is definitely second to the protagonist. Whereas in this story, I feel like Matt's almost the one that's starting better on top. And again, he's a great support system for Matt, which is good because it's nice to see good friendships in stories. And also, if he was a protagonist, there wouldn't really be as much room for him to grow. Because it's kind of gotten repetitive reading books that are about the same brave, selfless protagonist whose character development is limited to getting better at fighting and learning more things about the world due to the fact they don't have much room to grow. Whereas I really like how Matt has room to grow, and I definitely get the sense that he will grow. So this first section definitely felt more like a character introduction section. The plot didn't really go to the time travel part till the very end, and I get the sense that the later sections will be developing Matt's character and discovering how the time travel pendant works. I'm definitely interested to read more, and to be honest, since I haven't gotten to the time travel part, I don't know as much about whether it's more mystery, action, or adventure, because this was really just an introduction. However, I do recommend this for people who want relatable characters who have to deal with things such as bullying. And I also recommend this for someone interested in history because it is time travel and each episode is a different place in the past, which sounds really interesting. And I love history, so that sounds great for me. And I also recommend this for someone who likes reading short stuff or is busy and doesn't have much time to read, because it's actually pretty easy to read a quick section and be done, because I've been so busy and it's really nice to have something short I can read and get done in one night. In fact, I finished this section in one sitting because it's really not that long, but it's also pretty entertaining. And again, since I feel like I didn't get into a lot of the bulk of what the story is going to be for each section, because I feel like that the tone may shift for the time travel, I'm going to link my next review to this video when I read the next section. And I will see you later!